Welcome to Thorlabs. My name is Bill, and today I'm going to talk about a couple ways to align your laser beam. For today's demonstration, I have a collimated laser diode package, a few kinematic mounts, two that have mirrors already mounted on them, two irises, and a ruler. Now, before we begin, I'd like to take a moment to please ensure that you're following your institution's laser safety protocols. For this demonstration, I'm going to be using a Class 2 laser to ensure that the laser power is low for alignment purposes. So with our collimated laser diode packages and our fiber collimators, we have what's called a pointing angle. So we have the package and the front face, and so the hope would be that the light comes out parallel to the normal to that front face of that package. But in reality, the light's going to be pointing at some angle with respect to that normal direction. So because of this, I'll typically mount my devices in a kinematic mount. And a kinematic mount will give us a tip adjustment and a tilt adjustment that will allow us to counteract that angle and ensure that our beam is traveling in a straight line with respect to the table. So let's take a look. So here I'm going to take my laser, I'm going to mount it into my kinematic mount. So because the outer diameter of the laser is a little small, we're going to use an adapter to bring up the outer diameter to 1 inch. And we have nylon tip set screws within the adapter and also within the kinematic mount to ensure that we're not marring the surface of the laser or the adapter when we tighten everything in. So now that it's mounted, I'll turn the laser on. And so the first thing that I'll do is I'll take my ruler and I'll put it directly in front of the laser source. And so here I'll see that the beam is approximately 82 millimeters high. And so I'll take this ruler and I'll send it down the length of the table. And I see that I'm going in a downward direction down to 65 millimeters. So I'll adjust the tip axis and bring the beam up to approximately 82 millimeters. Now we've adjusted the actual source itself, so I'll bring the ruler back up close again to check the beam height. And now I'm a little bit closer to 83 millimeters. And when I bring it down to the end of the table, I'll do a slight adjustment until I feel confident that the light is now traveling at the same height along the length of the table. Now in the orthogonal direction is a little bit more difficult. We provide some tools to make this easier, but a lot of times you only have the single ruler. So in this case, I'll typically use a feature on the ruler and a feature on the table and line them up. And so here I'll use the flat edge of the ruler and the very edge of the tapped hole. And I'll see that the beam is near the longer deviation in the ruler. And so I'll bring this ruler down along the screw holes. You can see that I'm pretty far off. So I'll use the tilt axis to bring the beam closer to where I thought it was when I was up close. So again, I've moved the device, so I'm gonna come up close again. Take a look where I think it is. I'll make a slight tweak. Okay. So now I have my collimated laser diode package traveling in a straight line with respect to the table. In other cases, you might have a light source that you don't have adjustment. It might be coming out at a fixed height and you really can't do anything with it. So in this case, we might use two turning mirrors in order to adjust the beam height. So here I have my kinematic mirror mounts and I can use these to place them in the path. Let's slide this. And so now that the light is traveling down this row of screw holes, I'm going to send it down this row here. And I'll locate my mirror approximately in the center of the tapped hole and at a 45 degree angle. And now I'll take my other mirror and I'll pick a line I want to go and I'll put my mirror approximately down the center of that hole. Now I've already set the height of these mirrors to ensure that the beam stays within the inner third of the mirror. And that gives you extra range of adjustment and also prevents any possible aberrations in the optic. Now I'm going to take two irises and place them in the line. And I've already put these irises at approximately the same height. Essentially, I've taken the post holders and with the post inside all the way down to the bottom of the post holder. Now, ideally, you would place these irises very far apart, because the farther apart the two measurements, the more accurate you will be. But in this case, I'm keeping things relatively compact for this demonstration. In principle, I could do this with a single iris, just like I did with my ruler, and be moving that iris back and forth along the table. But by using the two irises, I can just keep them stationary and not have to be moving things all around. So here, I can see, looking at the front face of the iris, I can see that I'm hitting down and to the right. And so I'll use this first mirror mount to move the beam to try to center it on the aperture. And I know I'll be centered when there is a nice halo around the aperture. So now that I'm going through the center of the first iris, I look at the front face of the second iris, and I'm hitting down and to the left. And I'll use this second mirror mount to align the beam with the second iris. And as you can see, I kind of lost the laser power on the front face of the second iris because I'm blocking the beam with this first iris. So I'll come back to the first mirror mount and align the beam to the center. And then adjust again on the second iris with the second mirror mount. And I'll go back and forth between the two mounts to walk the beam into alignment. And once I have a nice halo on both faces of the irises, then I'm convinced myself that I'm now traveling in a straight line. So in general, it's always good practice to ensure that your laser beam is traveling in straight lines along the table. And we showed you a couple ways on how to make that happen. I hope this helps you in the lab someday. And if you have any questions, feel free to contact tech support.